everyone. It's very windy. I'm in the middle of a field somewhere in Poland. But what's significant about this specific field is that a narrow gauge railway used to run through its middle. That's the subject of today's video, as we go and look out for clues of this narrow gauge railway's existence. And the first, right behind me, is a beautiful viaduct which runs over a stream. So let's start.
As I walk up onto this viaduct, which runs over a stream called Michałówka, to look at the views on this historical landmark, here's a map on screen now of known stations on this branch line. It ran between Sroda Wielkopolska and Kobylepole, with stations at Pieszno, Szlachcin, Krerowo and Tulce on the way, but today we're only looking at this small section of the railway. So let's begin today's long trek by entering the forest.
Now this is a very beautiful path, but the thing to point out is as we're walking along the route of the railway, if you look to your right and to your left, you can see that the ground is very, very much lower than the path that you walk on, because this railway was built to run on a raised path, and that's very nice. So as I come off the path of the forest, we come here to this information board with some very nice information about the railway and some old photographs, and that's my cue to tell you a bit about the history of this railway.
So there isn't much information on this branch line, probably because it was one of the many narrow gauge railways that was taken apart in Poland. But what we do know is that this branch line was opened on the 23rd of June 1902, so 121 years ago, and it was taken apart between 1976 and 1979. The distance between the tracks was 1,000 millimeters, so only 1 meter. I then had a quick break for a very sour Mirabelle, and then I continued through the forest.
Now you see, while we're walking through this part of the forest, the path is actually beside where the tracks used to be, which were in a ditch, and they slowly rose out onto the field, which we're walking onto right now.
Next to the field I came out onto was the motorway, and soon I was back on the route of the railway's tracks, which I followed for a couple of minutes across the field, down a street, across the road,
to a very busy road from which you have to go onto a field through these red barriers. Which leads you here, next to this whole field of sweet corn, to where the next clue of this railway's existence is. It's another viaduct, over a different stream.
If you look to the side of the viaduct, you can see that there is a path through wildly growing plants leading directly to it, and is that an opportunity to climb on top of the bridge? Correct, and at this point it seemed inevitable that my trousers would get dirty. Oh well.
Yes, would you believe it? You're actually able to go onto the old bridge, and that allows some beautiful views from both sides of the little stream. But if you're not the climber type, I do not recommend this, because it was quite hard to get on top.
I'm on top of the bridge!
I then took the unmissable opportunity on eating fresh corn from the field.
That's very good.
And then continued down the field to this very old cobblestone road. Then across a bridge, walked forever through the confusing streets until something I'd been looking for a long time met my eyes.
Very calm, it's very nice. The sun is setting. We've asked a couple of people if they knew where the old Tulce station used to be, which was on the narrow gauge railway, and we found it. It's right behind me. And that's the end of us stepping back in time to look for clues of the existence of this narrow gauge railway. I hope you enjoyed the video. Press subscribe and like. Have a good day.